Hey guys, it's CCMN972, and I'm here at the new smithing place. And first, start off, you need a hammer, or you, depending on what you want to do, you need tongs, but not to mention you do need iron ores and bars. She says hi. Alright, so what we do is how we get here is east of Falador's Bank, or by the mining guild. It's called the Artisan's Workshop. And I do believe you can actually use the furnace for regular ores, or by storing the ores and then withdrawing it and then actually using it on an anvil. I haven't tried it yet. Don't really feel like trying it yet. But what you need to do to start off is you need to deposit in ores, and you just take your noted ore and click on it. You can do up to 4,000 any ores or 8,000 coal. So we're going to withdraw. Jeez, where's the button? Oh, we're gonna withdraw one. One level five. Oh, jeez, yeah, we gotta get a thingy too. And you have, for this, you have to have the, oh yeah, get a
hit up the bar, hit up the bar, hit up the bar.
Is it iron? Really? Really? I grabbed iron? Alright, so now I put that on there, and you get 29 times. Now, hard will take one chance, and you can hit it up to 5. You will never break this side, so don't worry about hitting it 3 times or twice with the hard. This is a careful is a guaranteed 1 to 0, but it uses, I think, 2 hits, I think I just used. Medium is good for 4. It'll do average of 2, but it'll hit 3, usually. Sometimes you'll fail, like just now. Music here's pretty good. It's not one of the better songs they've made, but... Alright, now we go back to soft. Ah, crap. Wow. And then you get a rating. If you get a perfect sword, you get to keep a good amount of EXP and stuff. So that's... I don't like that. That sucks. Now here's my favorite one. Now, obviously each thing does more. The higher the bar is, the more experience and the more the cost. The more efficient way to do this is rate by using rank 1. I do steel. And he says helmets, so I do helmets because I'll get more EXP. And there's a spirit. No, no, no! You suck. Killing a spirit will earn you favor or respect, and respect is required to purchase things. The EXP is actually pretty phenomenal. Oh, I just finished. And then when you're done with it, you deposit in the chute. You don't get respect doing this. You only earn respect for fixing the pipes, killing the spirits. Time to go downstairs. There's a midget down here. His name is Elf. Well, I have one respect. This was a 15, this was 20, or wait, maybe this was 15 and that was 10. All I know is it's worth it for the first one. For the second one, I don't know. It's not really worth that much, but you do earn a lot of crafting in smithing update. So I'm gonna take steel and gut, smith, one rail, one plate. That stops. Thank you. Stop it. Stop building crap. So then you start building the track, and once you build the track, you just keep smithing on the anvil. And, oh wow, yeah, I forgot about that. What, Skippy? Now, for non-numbers, this is pretty good smithing, but you have to have a certain level to do it. I think this one's 30, and when you're done with the track, you'll earn respect very slowly this way. I think you have to do like 100 tracks in order to earn like 4 respect, but then you'll lay the track, you'll get bonus EXP. Usually a full inventory of tracks will earn me 500 EXP, and then when you're done, you return in gods.
Where you put the unfinished ones in the little chest.
Now this one, I don't really want to show you because it burns up my... I've had bad experiences with this one before. You take the cannon base, you click on there, you'll get cogs. You use the cogs on the anvils. You'll use your bars on the anvils to make more on the fire to make more cogs. You'll need the molds, which are over here. Then you'll click back on your cannon. After you make 8 or 10, then you'll go to your next piece, which is the pipe. The stand. The stand requires 3 pipes, which is real easy. If you actually just make the pipes straight from the furnace, you won't fail. I've never failed. You put that back together. Then you take the head and you smack it on the anvil. You use it on the anvil 3 times and it'll repair it. Then you place that. Oh, by the way, you place everything on the center. And then you add the furnace. You use the flint and the charger on the anvil. And then you click on the gunpowder when it's full, and then you put it back together and do that, and then you make 2 sets of cannonballs, which is 8 total, and then you fire it, and you earn 3,200 experience. From all of this, you earn a golden cannon, or a regular upgraded cannon. It has no bonuses at all, it just looks a lot better. I right now have the regular cannon still. The regular cannon looks really phenomenal. I like it. Of course, I'm not really happy with this update because they gave us crap. Now, the ceremonial swords have stats. I don't know who has them, but you get to keep them. So we'll look for it. We'll look for it real quick. Here's what it looks like now. Oh, okay. So the cannons, every 3 cannons you build, you earn 3 respect. It takes 9 ancestors to get 1% respect. Respect is earned in the workshop. The respect seems to go up about 1% every 15 XP. It doesn't really say what else earns respect. It doesn't say about tracks. All I know is it says that cannons earn respect, but cannons require a lot of whatchamacallits. Anyways. Alright. So, the moral lesson of this, guys, is have fun, use it your own jurisdiction. Oh, there's a pipe. My pipe. See, now, if you tried to repair the pipe, you would take at least 7 hits. It only takes me 2. So, yeah. So, have fun, guys. Don't forget to rate, subscribe, sub, have fun. If you really want to donate, the link's down the bottom. Talk to me about posters, etc. Please message me on YouTube. Do not personal message me on RuneScape, on the clan chat. Have fun. Thanks, guys. All right. Bye.